Hi, welcome to Jesus for All 2, God's Word, Your Daily Bread, for November 26, 2021. Here you will hear daily readings of God's Word, the Bible, with the goal of hearing half of the Bible by January 9, 2022. The book of Isaiah, chapter 55, verse 10, reads, "For as the rain and the snow come down from the heavens, and return not there again, but water the earth, and make it bring forth and sprout, that it may give seed to the sower, and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes forth out of my mouth. It shall not return to me void, without producing an effect useless, but it shall accomplish that which I please and purpose, and it shall prosper in the thing for which I sent it." And Luke 11:28 says, "But he said, more than that, blessed are those who hear the word of God and keep it." And Psalm 107 verse 20 says, "He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from all their destructions." Amen. And we also know that Romans 10:17 says that so faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And so we shall hear this November 26, Psalm 82 and 83, Proverbs 26, because it is the 26th day of the month, and there are 31 Proverbs, one for every day of the month. The Old Testament reading will be from the book of Ezekiel, chapter 25, verse 1 through chapter 26, verse 21, and the New King James, the New Testament reading will be from the book of Hebrews, chapter 13, verse 1 through 25. All scriptures are taken from the New King James Version of the Bible, copyright 1982 by Thomas Nelson Incorporated, used by permission, all rights reserved. Amen. And now, Psalm 82 by Asaph. And it reads, please pardon me, I have a little scratchy throat. God stands in the congregation of the mighty. He judges among the gods. How long will you judge unjustly and show partiality to the wicked? Selah. Defend the poor and fatherless. Do justice to the afflicted and needy. Deliver the poor and needy. Free them from the hand of the wicked. For they do not know, nor do they understand. They walk about in darkness. All the foundations of the earth are unstable. I said, you are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High. But you shall die like men and fall like one of the princes. Verse 8 and last. Arise, O God, judge the earth, for you shall inherit all nations. Pardon me. And now Psalm 83, also a psalm of Asaph. And it reads, do not keep silent, O God, do not hold your peace. And do not be still, O God, for behold, your enemies make a tumult, and those who hate you have lifted up their head. They have taken crafty counsel against your people and consulted together against your sheltered ones. They have said, come, and let us cut them off from being a nation, that the name of Israel may be remembered no more. For they have consulted together with one consent. They form a confederacy against you. The tents of Edom and Ishmaelites, Moab and the Hagrites, Gebal, Ammon, and the Amalekites, Philistia with the inhabitants of Tyre. Assyria also has joined with them. They have helped the children of Lot. Deal with them as with Midian, as with Sisera, as with Jabin at the brook of Kishon, who perished at Endor, who became as refuse on the earth. Make their nobles like Oreb, and like Zeb, yes, all their princes like Zeba and Zalmanua, who said, let us take for ourselves the pastures of God for a possession. O my God, make them like the whirling dust, like the chaff before the wind. As the fire burns the woods, and as the flame sets the mountains on fire, so pursue them with your tempest, and frighten them with your storm. Fill their faces with shame, that they may seek your name, O Lord. Let them be confounded and dismayed forever. Yes, let them be put to shame and perish. Verse 18 and last, that they may know that you, whose name alone is the Lord, are the Most High over all the earth. Amen and amen and amen in Jesus' name. And this word is already blessed. And now, Proverbs 26, and it reads, as snow in summer and rain in harvest, so honor is not fitting for a fool. Like a flitting sparrow, like a flying swallow, so a curse without a cause shall not alight. A whip for the horse, a bridle for the donkey, and a rod for the fool's back. Do not answer a fool according to his folly, lest you also be like him. Answer a fool according to his folly, lest he be wise in his own eyes. He who sends a message by the hand of a fool cuts off his own feet and drinks violence. Like the legs of the lame that hang limp is a proverb in the mouth of fools. Like one who binds a stone in a sling is he who gives honor to a fool. Like a thorn that goes into the hand of a drunkard is a proverb in the mouth of fools. The great God who formed everything gives the fool his hire and the transgressor his wages. As a dog returns to his own vomit, so a fool repeats his folly. Do you see a man wise in his own eyes? There is more hope for a fool than for him. The lazy man says there is a lion in the road. A fierce lion is in the streets. As a door turns on its hinges, so does the lazy man on his bed. The lazy man buries his hand in the bowl. It wearies him to bring it back to his mouth. The lazy man is wiser in his own eyes than seven men who can answer sensibly. Verse 17. He who passes by and meddles in a quarrel, not his own, is like one who takes a dog by the ears, like a madman who throws firebrands, arrows, and death. Is the man who deceives his neighbor and says, I was only joking. Where there is no food, the fire goes out. Where there is no wood, the fire goes out. And where there is no talebearer, strife ceases. As charcoal is to burning coals and wood to fire, so is a contentious man to kindle strife. The words of a talebearer are like tasty trifles, and they go down into the innermost body. Fervent lips with a wicked heart are like earthenware covered with silver dross. He who hates disguises it with his lips and lays up deceit within himself. When he speaks kindly, do not believe him, for there are seven abominations in his heart. Though his hatred is covered by deceit, his wickedness will be revealed before the assembly. Whoever digs a pit will fall into it, and he who rolls a stone will have it roll back on him. Verse 28 and last. A lying tongue hates those who are crushed by it, and a flattering mouth works ruin. Amen and amen. And the word in the mighty name of Jesus Christ is already blessed. And now, the Old Testament reading from the book of Ezekiel, beginning at chapter 25. And it reads, the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, set your face against the Ammonites, and prophesy against them. Say to the Ammonites, hear the word of the Lord God. Thus says the Lord God, because you said, aha, against my sanctuary when it was profaned, and against the land of Israel when it was desolate, and against the house of Judah when they went into captivity. Indeed, therefore, I will deliver you as a possession to the men of the east, and they shall set their encampments among you, and make their dwellings among you. They shall eat your fruit, and they shall drink your milk. And I will make Rabbah a stable for camels, and Ammon a resting place for flocks. Then you shall know that I am the Lord. For thus says the Lord God, because you clapped your hands, stamped your feet, and rejoiced in heart with all your disdain for the land of Israel, indeed Therefore, I will stretch out my hand against you and give you as plunder to the nations. I will cut you off from the peoples, and I will cause you to perish from the countries. I will destroy you, and you shall know that I am the Lord. Verse 8. Thus says the Lord God, because Moab and Seir say, look, the house of Judah is like all the nations. Therefore, behold, I will clear the territory of Moab of cities, of the cities on its frontier, the glory of the country, Beth Jesmon, Baal Meon, and Kirjathaim. To the men of the east I will give it as a possession, together with the Ammonites, and the Ammonites may not be remembered, that the Ammonites may not be remembered among the nations. Verse 11. And I will execute judgments upon Moab, and they shall know that I am the Lord. Verse 12. Thus says the Lord God, because of what Edom did against the house of Judah by taking vengeance, and has greatly offended by avenging itself on them, therefore thus says the Lord God, I will also stretch out my hand against Edom, cut off man and beast from it, and make it desolate from Teman. Dedan shall fall by the sword. I will lay my vengeance on Edom by the hand of my people Israel, that they may do in Edom according to my anger and according to my fury, and they shall know my vengeance, says the Lord God. Verse 15. Thus says the Lord God, because the Philistines dealt vengefully and took vengeance with a spiteful heart to destroy the because of the old hatred. Therefore, thus says the Lord God, I will stretch out my hand against the Philistines, and I will cut off the Chephthites and destroy the remnant of the seacoast. I will execute great vengeance on them with furious rebukes, and they shall know that I am the Lord when I lay my vengeance upon them. Chapter 26. And it shall come to pass in the 11th year, on the first day of the month, that the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Son of man, because Tyre has said against Jerusalem, Aha, she is broken, who was the gateway of the peoples. Now she is turned over to me, I shall be filled, she is laid waste. Therefore thus says the Lord God, behold, I am against you, O Tyre, and will cause many nations to come up against you, as the sea causes its waves to come up. And they shall destroy the walls of Tyre and bring down her towers. I will also scrape her dust from her and make her like the top of a rock. It shall be a place for spreading nets in the midst of the sea. For I have spoken, says the Lord God, it shall become plunder for the nations. Also her daughter, villages which are in the field, shall be slain by the sword. Then they shall know that I am the Lord. Verse 7, for thus says the Lord God, behold, I will bring against Tyre from the north Nebuchadnezzar, king of Babylon, king of kings, with horses, with chariots, and with horsemen, and an army with many people. He will slay with the sword your daughter, villages in the fields. He will heap up a siege mount against you, build a wall against you, and raise a defense against you. He will direct his battering rams against your walls, and with his axes he will break down your towers. Because of the abundance of his horses, their dust will cover you. Your walls will shake at the noise of the horsemen, the wagons, and the chariots when he enters your gates, as men enter a city that has been breached. With the hoofs of his horses he will trample all your streets. He will slay your people by the sword, and your strong pillars will fall to the ground. They will plunder your riches and pillage your merchandise. They will break down your walls and destroy your pleasant houses. They will lay your stones, your timber, and your soil in the midst of the water. I will put an end to the sound of your songs, and the sound of your harps shall be heard no more. Verse 14, I will make you like the top of a rock. You shall be a place for spreading nets, and you shall never be rebuilt. For I, the Lord, have spoken, says the Lord God. Verse 15. Thus says the Lord God to Tyre, will the coastland not shake to the sound of your fall, when the wounded cry, when slaughter is made in the midst of you? Then all the princes of the sea will come down from their thrones, lay aside their robes, and take off their embroidered garments. They will clothe themselves with trembling. They will sit on the ground, tremble every moment, and be astonished at you. And they will take up a lamentation for you and say to you, how you have perished, O one inhabited by seafaring men, O renowned city who was strong at sea, she and her inhabitants who caused their terror to be on all her inhabitants. Now the coastlands tremble on the day of your fall. Yes, the coastlands by the sea are troubled at your departure. Verse 19, for thus says the Lord God, when I made you a desolate city like cities that are not inhabited, when I bring the deep upon you and great waters cover you, then I will bring you down with those who descend into the pit, to the people of old, and I will make you dwell in the lowest parts of the earth, in places desolate from antiquity, with those who go down into the pit, so that you may never be inhabited, and I shall establish glory in the land of the living. Verse 21 and last. I will make you a terror, and you shall be no more. Though you are sought for, you will never be found again, says the Lord God. And this word in the mighty name of Jesus Christ is already blessed. And now the New Testament reading from the book of Hebrews, beginning at chapter 13. And it reads, let brotherly love continue. Do not forget to entertain strangers, for by doing so, some have unwittingly entertained angels. Remember the prisoners as if chained with them, those who are mistreated, since you yourselves are in the body also. Marriage is honorable among all, and the bed undefiled, but fornicators and adulterers God will judge. Let your conduct be without covetousness. Be content with such things as you have. For he himself has said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. So we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper. I will not fear. What can man do to me? Verse 7. Remember those who rule over you, who have spoken the word of God to you, whose faith follow, considering the outcome of their conduct. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Do not be carried about with various and strange doctrines, for it is good that the heart be established by grace, not with foods which have not profited those who have been occupied with them. We have an altar from which those who serve the tabernacle have no right to eat. For the bodies of those animals whose blood is brought into the sanctuary by the high priest for sin are burned outside the camp. Therefore Jesus also, that he might sanctify the people with his own blood, suffered outside the gate. Therefore let us go forth to him outside the camp, bearing his reproach. For there we have no continuing city, but we seek the one to come. Therefore by him let us continually offer the sacrifice of praise to God, that is the fruit of our lips, giving thanks to his name. But do not forget to do good and to share, for with such sacrifices God is well pleased. Obey those who rule over you and be submissive, for they watch out for your souls as those who must give an account. Let them do so with joy and not with grief, for that would be unprofitable for you. Verse 18. Pray for us, for we are confident that we have a good conscience in all things, desiring to live honorably. But I especially urge you to do this, that I may be restored to you the sooner. Verse 20. Now may the God of peace, who brought up our Lord Jesus from the dead, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you complete in every good work to do his will, working in you what is well-pleasing in his sight through Jesus Christ, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. And I appeal to you, brethren, bear with the word of exhortation, for I have written to you in few words. Know that our brother Timothy has been set free, with whom I shall see you if he comes shortly. Greet all those who rule over you, and all the saints, those from Italy, greet you. Grace be with you all. Amen. And the word in the mighty name of Jesus Christ is already blessed. Hallelujah and glory to God in the highest. May the word that you have heard in the mighty name of Jesus Christ profit you. And may this word, as it has gone forth, heal you and deliver you from every destruction, as it is written in Psalm 107, verse 20. And the word cannot lie. Amen, 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 in Jesus' name.